Hey, so I wanted to talk a bit about this piece I am redoing. This is the original. I used a piece of scrapbook paper. So you see these lines that go vertically? These were part of the original scrapbooking paper. And I just liked the way that that looked and decided I wanted to put a face. And so I drew this girl and gave her hair and sea turtles. And she's kind of just this mermaid. And I love this. The way the illustration came out. I like the colors and the illustrative quality of the turtles. And so there's a cat in here pulling it out. Cat, stop. Okay. So I wanted to replicate that. And in this scrap of paper, it has kind of like a scaly texture. Cat, stop it. The scaly texture. And then in these lines, they're also textured with like flowers. It's something floral. You can see in her eye, there's a flower coming out right here. But it's kind of indiscernible pretty much. So in order to replicate that, here's my canvas and what I've done so far. I've painted it. I just used these colors. They're white and gold, and there's a lighter one and a slightly darker one, and I used some white, and I did a base coat of the white and the lightest color across the whole piece. On top of that, I used the darker color here to make the scaly look, only I just used this bubble wrap. Cat! Hey! Stop scratching. And I just put it flat on a palette and rubbed on, and then stamp, stamp, stamp. Of course it's drying out. And then I, after that, I went over again with some white, but now I see it's hardly discernible, so I don't know what the point of that was. There's a little bit right here. And then I took my tracing paper, and that's backwards. I traced her on my my light table and transferred the image with graphite. So now I have the graphite image, and I'm taking a very, very dark bluish. I put iridescent medium in here, and it's not really showing up. I don't think there was any point. And then, so that's for my line work. It's all a nearly black. It's like charcoal with a little blue in it, nearly black for all the line work. And here's the reason for the scratching. So, and this is kind of a big piece. I don't usually do them this big. That's why I have it sitting on the floor. I'm painting this on the floor. And then I think I'm going to do a limited color palette. The turtles, just like in the original, are going to be those browns, and I can just mix them because I can just mix anything I want. And then I'll have her with the turquoise hair. And originally I just did this with marker. I just did it once with marker, and it turned out like this is what I use for my business cards. And I love that her hair is just like ocean hair. So after I have finished with all of the line work, I will come back and give another report.
Just for fun, you can use a flat one if you want. And I would dip in to my paint, dollar store shot glass, and then dip into, I hold them both and just kneel here the whole time, and then dip into some water with Flow Aid until you get the consistency you're happy with. And then you start wherever you want it dark and work your way to light. But you don't want it to get too thin. You have to be careful with acrylic. If it's got too much water in it, the polymers will break down and won't hold for a long time. You wind up with paint cracking off because the bond isn't strong enough. That's why I have the Flow Aid in there. That kind of helps. So I just smooth it out until it gets to where it's light in the light areas. So I did that with all the hair, and it kind of gives a little bit of a watercolor effect. And then to do the highlights where the light hits in these sections, I'm just going back in with the color I used in the background. I'm using the same brush. It says it's a 1.5. Or no, it's a 1/2, not a 1.5. And then I'm just using straight paint out of the tube and going over where I want it to be light. That's what I did here. That's what I did here. And you just do a little bit at a time. And it has some texture. I'll show you a close-up in a minute. But it, that way, I just go back and forth and build until I like the way that the hair looks. Like, I feel like it needs something up here. So I'll just add some of the light color, avoiding the line work.
Which has already been painted over, so it's subdued, but I can bring that back after if I like, if I want it. But I think I'm going to leave some of the line work kind of muddled in the background. I don't know if I like it here. If you don't like where you put highlights, you just paint the turquoise over it again, or whatever hair color you choose. And that's how I do the hair. Okay. So this is kind of an up close of what the hair texture. You can see the brush strokes. And that's just the way that this style of painting comes out. And I like it sometimes, and sometimes I don't want to see brush strokes, but for this one I want it to come through as if it were the background coming through. I want some transparency. Or a facade of transparency. So this is the finished hair. I only colored it in. If I do line work, you'll see that later on top. Look at that turtle face. Turtle face. So these are some colors I already had mixed from my Dumbledore painting, and they just happen to be the same as the sea turtles. So I'm gonna use those. So there's the original turtle with marker, and that is what I've painted. It's a little bit more on the purple side, although the lighting in the camera, you can't see exactly what it looks like. It looks kind of close on my screen, but all monitors are different, so it actually looks a little more purple. And then the original one was more orange. I guess you can kind of tell it's more orange. But it's a different technique on a different medium, so you can't expect to color match exactly, even if you do all your mixing. It's still gonna look a little different. So now I gotta do the other turtles, but I'm calling it a quits. I did her lips and her eyes. The brown is the same brown, and the lipstick is the same as in the back of the tortoise shell. Or tortoise. Turtle. Sea turtle shell. So I'm leaving it like that. See you later. Okay, so I've got a progress report. I finished the turtles, and I've added some shading in the skin. I haven't quite decided if I'm going to do scales on the fin portion of her body. I haven't gotten that far, but that turtle's done. I haven't done anything else to the hair. I worked a little bit on the eyes and the lips a little when I went up and did the shading on the face. And this little turtle's done too. So to do the skin, because here's the original where I used gray in order to shade the flesh and stuff. So I didn't use any flesh tones. But here I'm using warm colors. So first, I went in with this. This is the color I used to do the bubble wrap texture. I just did that in the shadow areas. And then I mixed a little bit of that with just a teeny bit of the color I used to line it. And came up with this kind of other, it's just a little bit darker. And then I went over and did a little bit of the darker shadows with that. And after that, it can get to look a little kind of stark. So I go back with this, the light, and with that I just water it down a little bit and dry brush it in to make it all just overlap a little bit, and when that dries it's slightly translucent so you can see through to the shading below, but it makes it softer, especially in areas like this where you have shading but you can't really just, like, this is a very, like, that's her nose shadow, it's obvious, but here it's just kind of alluding to, if this wasn't darker this wouldn't look as prominent and pointy and nose-like. So that's where I am now. Now I'm going in with some white. I just have it in a little glass, and I have this, I just spray a little bit of water inside my shot glass, and then I mix it up just a little bit, and then I dry brush it across here is where I just put it. So I don't know if you can really tell on the camera, the difference between this and this is just dry brushing white over the center of the lightest portion. So I'm going to try and demonstrate that, but I'm holding the camera with one hand, so this is kind of, let's see if it's focused. Come on, camera. Okay, so I'm going to do this section here. You just do the center, and you work your way out a little. When your brush starts drying, you can spread it out a little farther. Me a little more. But that way, because I had layered that other lighter color earlier, it's a more gradual fade. And it's not just, oh, I'm losing my camera. It's a gradual fade, and it's not just like white with lines. It's just a slightly different effect. Because you can do it. It'll look nice. Because see, in the drawing, obviously, I used marker. So it's just, I didn't use any white on top, but I did the turquoise. I just did it in with that shape and left it blank there, and it's just a line, and you can paint that way too. But for some reason I do what I like. I like this. And that's all. It's pretty simple. Start in the center. Wow, I'm not showing what I'm doing. And then work your way around where you want it. And it just makes it a little lighter. But overall, the effect is way greater from a distance when you go to zoom out. Just the difference between this, obviously this pops out significantly more than this here. And you can use that to your advantage when you want to draw someone's focus to something. You make high contrast. See, the turtles, they have a lot of contrast on their own. I haven't added any white in them. I think I'm only going to put white in the little eye of the turtle. Little turtle. So the only thing I'm going to do with him is, oh, I'm looking at the camera. That, there. Now it's eye pops. And I'll do this guy too. He's got two. Let's see if I can do this while I'm using the camera as a viewfinder here. It's kind of weird. Boop. Oh, I'm cutting it off a little. Boop. Painting with the camera. But now he stares at you. See, those turtles don't have that. They just have like little black. Here, he's like, I'm looking at you. And I got one more little turtle. Boop. You see the difference in just that one little white dot? There you go. Can do that to her too. I haven't touched her eyes at all. And I think I want them. Let's see if I can do this. This is a real challenge here. Film painting. So which eye stands out more? Just a little white. And you might think, well, is that even worth doing? You're the only one who's gonna know about it because you're the only one who saw it while you were painting it, but it's all the little things that add up. I'm gonna put some in the skin too. As long as it's kind of thin, maybe add some flow aid. I'm just using a little bit of water. I know I want a reflection in her lip. Sometimes I'll do this, but I won't be able to dry brush and I'll just take it away with my finger. And maybe that's not enough and then I'll go back in with some more. Just give her a little shine. And white is really my favorite. I love adding highlights. Just the bridge of the nose. Maybe we'll come up into the forehead a little and kind of rub it around into the fibers of the canvas. Well, fibers are pretty much coated by now, but my arm is getting tired, so I'm gonna finish this up quick. I might reline part of her nose in this little nook. Can't decide. But there, now her whole face just pops out that much more. We need just a little highlight here. And on the cheek. I'm not getting enough water here. Just spread that a little. That doesn't really come across on camera, but the rest of it does. So now just her face is a little bit prettier. That turtle's eyes. They're really peeking. Okay. And that's it for this checkup.
So I've just done the tail. Well, not the, you know, I'm not having a fin. I'm just doing the tail. So in order to get this effect, and I've also gone and done the tail color on the skin. I even put it on her face. I got brave and I put it on her face. But I'm going to go over that a little bit more with the skin tone and the dark shade and the light, just to tone it back a little. But I wanted something up there that had the same texture as the skin lower down. So in order to do this, I took the hair color, which is obviously brighter. I used the hair color just after at the end. But I took the hair color and I mixed this with the darker skin color with the first set of bubble wrap printing plus hair color equals this kind of weird greeny goo. So that is what I used for the fin. Before I painted this whole section, like, I basically did the same thing you do in the hair, but just on a big scale. It's like one giant piece of hair, basically. I did do the bubble wrap first, and then I painted, waited for that to dry, and then I painted just vertical strokes, kind of darker at the edges, trying to avoid the turtle, and then I did the hair color. And I just put it on the edge of my brush and I went down around so that it would have a little bit of shading. And then I let that dry and I went back with the bubble wrap and the hair color and I just did that on top down here. I don't like this, it's too much. If it's too much, you just go over it again with the lighter tone with a little, you know, thinner. So I'm gonna get to fixing the skin tone that I did on her face, and then I'll check in again, because that just seems like a little too much lichen or whatever growing on her face. Okay, so she's done. I'm gonna leave her alone. I only put highlights and a little bit of the hair, but I finished the skin and I went over some of the line work again. Haven't touched the turtles, but this is something that I just decided to add while I was doing the skin. And this is what most people just call it, bounce light. But it's a highlight that comes from underneath a reflective surface. I know she's just kind of floating in space, but having this, I don't know why I like it, but I like it. And you see in a lot of comic books, and I really like comic books, so I stole something I found in a comic book. So this is where the bounce light's coming from, and this side is the more shadow side. And that is reflected in how I did some of the highlighting in the skin. I don't know how much you're going to be able to see on camera, but there's just, I went over where I had used the bubble wrap with the dark, and I just went over with the skin tone, and then I did the darks again, especially here on the face. This big, that spot was, like, too much, but I just made it subdued. I went over and shaded it. Same process, but just on top, and I did the line work on her nose a little bit nicer. I touched up her eyelashes because they had gotten turquoise like up here and stuff. Some of the line work, obviously I didn't want it perfect. I like how it's scumbled. I like how the paint kind of overlaps it a little bit. So where it had completely disappeared, like here in the back, I wanted it darker. It's a thing you kind of have to step back and look at from a distance, like what do you want to pop out. Like down here I did just a teeny bit, like some areas. I don't know, I like it kind of messy looking. That was just the style of this piece that I chose. So I only highlighted here in the hair because it brings your attention here. If I would highlight like up here, like I don't want people looking up there, it just dissipates into the sides. I want it to be like, whoa, that's a lot of contrast in the face, and then you look at it. Whereas in this one, you just kind of let it disappear. Face is really high contrast. The turtle is a lot more shadow. I didn't really get the same effect with the paint, because every time you put a layer over for a shadow, it's not the same as marker where you can see everything underneath. Here it actually is somewhat opaque. So, aside from them being different colors and a different medium, I really like the way that this one turned out, especially the shell. The other two, the shell didn't show so much. But, yeah. So that's how I finished her. And sign and date. And then that's it. And that's my mermaid. Let's get a good close up here. And a little comparison shot to the drawing. Her eyebrows stand out a lot more in that one for some reason. Yep, and that's it. Let's just sniff. Okay, sorry. Hope I don't get flagged for nudity. There's no nipple, so I don't think I can, but you know, people do that. But it's art. So you know how you think you're done with something and then you realize you have iridescent medium and it needs to be sparkly like everywhere? So that's what just happened. Let's see if I can find an angle where you can actually see it. There it is. It's in the hair. You see it? It's hard to see. It just looks like it's wet on the camera. Anyway, she is sparkly all over the place. And something else that I rarely see on YouTube, for I don't know why. I guess it's because you can't see it happening, so it's boring. But I'm just gonna mention it. Varnish. I use a satin varnish. And make sure you always put it in a clean container, because it might pick up on the color if you put it in like a dirty one. So I just 2 coats of that, and try to make sure you don't have any bubbles or anything. It's really thin. It's really not that big a deal. But anyway, I know you can't really tell, but she's just shiny all over the place. Thought I'd mention that. So yeah, I'm gonna give a good coat of varnish on her, and then 3 hours drying time, I believe. And then another coat. And yeah. They want you to apply gloss varnish first for the first coat, but I don't have any, so maybe I'll just do 2 coats of this. I really wish I could see that she was shiny. Like, maybe I can work with this lamp. There it is. Oh, it went away. Well, you saw it for a moment. Sparkly there, yeah. You can see it better before it focuses. There's the sheen. Super shiny lady. I didn't make the turtle shiny. They are plain. Her lips are shiny. Right there. We get this up close, maybe? I don't know. That's the best you get, though. Okay.